Alola. And what's the chat, chat? Josh PH Games here. Welcome back to another episode of the Pokemon Sun Let's Play. In the last episode, we finally took on our second grand trial. And we also met up with a member of the Alder Foundation, and they asked us to come here to the Hundo Grand Resort, which we are doing in today's episode. So, let's take a look at this team rather quickly before we go in there. So first off, we have Crunol, level 30, but I did do some grinding. Crunol has Spark, Skull, Confuse Ray, and Signal Beam. Then we have Roderick, level 33, with Scratch, Fire Fang, Bite, and Lick. Then we have Woody, level 32, with Pluck, Roost, Beak Blast, and Brick Break. Then we have Roxy, level 31, with Accelerock, Rock Tomb, Bite, and Stealth Rocks. It is also holding the Rockium Z, so it can know Continental Crush. Yeah. Roderick has the fiery Rum Z, so it can learn the Fire Type Z move, which I can't remember off the top of my head what that's called. And then we have Crunol is also holding the Waterism Z, so that is Hydro Vortex. I haven't seen the fire one yet, but we'll see it in a couple minutes, hopefully. If we get time, I might try and see it in today's episode. Then we have Sophie, level 31, with Fury Swipe, Swift, Fake Out, and Feint Attack. And then we have Seeds, level 32, with Fairy Wind, Giga Drain, Leech Seed, and Stun Spore. Holding the Eevee Light, because the fact is, you know, Seeds has still got to evolve yet, so might as well be a tank whilst I'm waiting around to evolve it. Hello, mate. So you came at last. But forgive me, I have yet to introduce myself. You may call me Fabia. I told you before, that I was going to show you someplace astounding. Well, right. It's a wondrous place. It's called the Alder Paradise. Let me tell you about the Alder Paradise. Just as the name suggests, Alder Paradise is, it's a variable paradise for Pokemon that floats far out in the surrounding sea of the Alola. It's an actual island made from human technology for protecting Pokemon. Of course, I'm an adult who keeps his promises, so I will prove to you what I've told you is absolute truth. With a tour of the Alder Paradise, you'll come, won't you? Sure, why not? Good. Then you come with me to the Alder Paradise. It will amaze you. Wait, take me to war. Even Kahuna Olivia has come to see you off. As a Kahuna, I look after all trial goers who come to my island as if they were my own children. Damn police cars going past again. Not that I've got any or ever been gotten married. Oh, don't worry, Olivia. Someone will marry you eventually. Hey, maybe my old my character in the game will marry you. Nah, I'm more into Lily. Listen up, you two. The greatest opponent is always yourself. Your greatest allies are the Pokemon beside you. Thanks. You coming too, Professor? Nah, I got my own business to attend to. I won't be coming. You go and see the amazing tech that Alder is developing and tell me about it, yeah? That's right. I'll see you on the next island. Ula Island. Yeah. Let's meet up in Melee Garden. Yep, it's goodbye from Alaka Island. Though I guess we'll have to come back here sometime if we can come back here any time if we want to. Let's us enjoy our adventure up on to that grand vessel. That'll take us across the high seas. Which is to say, the ferry. Okay. Which he knows. Can you believe a big hunk of iron like Alder Paradise can float in the sea? It's because of the Pokemon holding it up. Did you know that, Joel? I knew that. Oh, I thought I had one up on you. Oh, I can't wait to actually see it. The Alder Paradise for myself. And we're going all the way over to here. Welcome to the Alder Paradise. Alder Paradise. I like the music here. It's very interesting. Here we are, you two. This is the Alder Paradise. The Alder Paradise is a facility created for the conservation of Pokemon. It has been outfitted with all the latest technology for this purpose. Downstairs, the teams are working on brand new Pokeballs and so much more. Yes, for all for the sake of Pokemon conservation. Though, you will not be able to use any Pokeballs within the Alder Paradise. Well, there are no wild Pokemon in the Alder Paradise, so there's nothing I can do about that. A jamming signal is broadcast throughout the facility that prevents them from functioning. Really? Okay. I will take your word for it. You know, that's some interesting tech there you have to to make that happen. It must be some very, very interesting tech. Oh, excuse me, Mr. Fabia. Yes, excuse you. What is the meaning of that formal address? I have a title for a reason. How else would anyone know how important I am? So, yes, Branch Manager Fabia. Now I must go and speak with the president about our conservation efforts on Alaka. Show these children around and take them to meet the president as well, would you? Phew. Welcome to Alder Paradise, Joe and Hal. My name is Wiki. Alola. Wait, you know who we are. How do you know that? One of our employees told us about you from a meeting on Alaka Island. Oh, so one of your grunts. Okay. And of course, I'd heard that you helped protect the Pokemon over there, young Mr. Howe. Thank you very much. Let me show you around. The main entrance is just up above us. Okay. Shall we zip right up? Okay, so this is the main entrance. You can have your Pokemon taken care of at that reception desk if you ever need it. Joe, you and Hal are both trial goers, aren't you? And you're hoping to become champions. Maybe, I don't know. I haven't really thought about it. I suppose you must be around 11 then? What do you know? Yeah, this is my first chance that I had to join the Island Challenge since I only just turned 11. Because someday I really want to beat my Gramps, but he is way too strong. How lovely for you. I suppose all children must learn to take a journey of their own choosing when they get to about your age. Though they're just children anymore. Trainers are like parents to their Pokemon. They are like parents to their Pokemon. My Pokemon are like my children in a way. That I've never really thought of it like that, but yeah, she's right. She is right. This wiki is right. You know, we're like parents to Pokemon. That's good. Joe, Hal. Would you two like to see the conservation area upstairs? Sure, why not? We'll zip right up. Ah, this is the place from the main area from the opening sequence of the game. Well, the paradise is a safe haven for all Pokemon. For that reason, the use of Pokeballs is strictly forbidden within this conservation area. Wow. We keep Pokemon that have been targeted by Team Skull here. And we also try to support Pokemon that need a little extra protection. Like Corsola, for example. They are terribly overhunted by a Pokemon called Torkoax. Yes, Torkoax is a really interesting Pokemon. There's only one way to actually get a Torkoax. It's not available. It's technically not available in the wild. What you need to do to actually hunt one down is to find a Corsola out on an island later on. I think it's called Pony Island later on. It's like the fourth island. Anyway, so you find Corsola out on that route, and basically what you want to do is you want to beat that Corsola up all the way until it calls for help, and then there's a random chance it'll call a Torkoax to the battle as an SOS Pokemon. But the thing is about Toxapex is, and its evolution is, they eat Corsola. I think its evolution spits out pieces of Corsola as it's going through the water. So they're really dangerous Pokemon, and it's not a very good idea for a Corsola to call this Pokemon into battle to help it out. Because it doesn't want to help. It just wants to eat it. I hope I don't mind. I hope you don't mind if I read a passage from its Pokédex. Toxapex crawls along the ocean floor on its 12 legs, leaving a trail of Corsola bits. See? A trail of Corsola bits. That's exactly what I mean. And scattered in its wake, so it literally just drops out Corsola bits. The bits of Corsola. So, really, I feel bad for Corsola, because it's one of those Pokemon that I actually really like. It's just, it never got anything, because it's one of those... It's one of those Pokemon that Gen 2 sort of, well, to pardon my French, it really did do a number two on that on Corsola. Because Corsola never got any evolution, never got any kind of recognition. The only kind of recognition that Corsola got is basically Misty caught one in the anime. That's basically the only thing Corsola had going for it. Misty caught one in the anime. Nobody had one. I think that's like one or two Pokemon that was on it. One or two trainers had a Corsola on their team throughout the entire Gold, Silver, and Crystal. This Pokemon was barely ever used, barely ever found, and it was just... I feel so bad for it, because it could have, they could have done so much with Corsola. It could have been such a good Pokemon. But it just left it alone and got nothing from it. Yeah, my Gramps is always... saying that nature has got its cruel sides, but it's also got its blessings. But can the older Federation really protect all the Pokemon out there? Nature does have its own balance, of course. It can be difficult to judge just how much humans should try to affect that, couldn't it? Can't it? That's pretty amazing. The older Federation seems to... It seems so awesome. But why would you why do you bother setting up a bunch... A branch in a place like Alola? I couldn't say. It's hard to know what our president is thinking sometimes. If you'd like to meet our president, I would like to meet your president. She is, she should be around the conservation area right now. I do want to meet your president, but first, I want to go back down to the entrance and heal up my Pokemon. Because I believe there's a battle coming up, and it's a very important battle, so I would like to, Oh. Fine. I guess you won't heal my Pokemon up. Fine. Right. Now my Pokemon should be fully healed. Oh yeah, off-screen I caught a Sandygeist as well. Because they're available on the beach near the Hundo Grand Resort, so I've got a Sandygeist now too. I just want to be ready for this battle, because it's a very important battle that I gotta face, and I don't really want to face it, but I'm gonna face it. I guess I don't really need repels around here, because there's no wild Pokemon, and I can't catch Pokemon anyway, so there's no real point in using repels. So there's a few interesting Pokemon around here. There's some Alolan Grimer. Ah, I think... There we are. Hello. My sweet Pokemon. I promise to keep you all safe. I'll protect you with my love. Ah. You must be Joe and Hal. Welcome to the Older Paradise, the Older Federation's own private island. I am the president of that federation, but please, just call me Lusamine. I'm so glad that we had a chance to meet. I'm glad there are people like you who travel the islands to learn more about Pokemon. But there is also those unformidable people who harm Pokemon for their own selfish reasons, or even for profit. That is why I am here. I will be like a mother to those pure Pokemon and shower them with my love. You will be showered with my love. Even Pokemon from distant worlds, far from the Alola region, are worthy of my love. Everyone is worthy of my love. Wow, Mrs. Lusamine. I don't know how you do all this, but yeah, you're not even that much older than us. Are you really trying to flirt with Lusamine? You barely even met the girl, and you're trying to flirt with her. Damn you, Hal. What the hell is with your self-confidence? Like, you must be the worst trainer in the world, but the fact is, you're willing to flirt with a girl you've met barely 5 minutes. Well done to yourself. Well done. Pat yourself on the back, Hal. Amazing. Like, can you... Honest question of the day for all the boys out there. Can you flirt with a girl that you've just met? Can you flirt with someone you've just met? It even works for girls and other people as well. And all kinds of sexuality. Can you just actually just go up to someone and flirt? I can't do that. I just can't do that. I am unconfident in that way, but I want to know. Question of the day. Ooh, you sweet boy. But I'm already over 40. Wow. She must be using some kind of amazing makeup to cover herself up, or a lot of surgeries or something like that, for she's very old. But, you know, sometimes it does happen like that. Sometimes, you know, you can be like 40 and over 40 and still look like you're 20 and do nothing to, do nothing to your looks, and it's, you know, you don't put makeup on or something, or any kind of eye cream or age cream or anything like that, or stuff like that. You don't put any of that stuff on, and you don't and your age just doesn't show. You know, I'm not sure if my age shows. Again, I could ask you guys what age you think I am, but you should already know what age I am. 28. But like, I don't know if I look 28. That's the thing, I'm not exactly sure I look 28. You are? Wait, what? I think he just realized what he tried to do. Oh, you. Well, she still liked it. I call her a pass on your behalf, you know? Go and try it. She probably, you know, I'd probably go and try that if it was you or Hal, you know? I think there's a certain four-letter word you could call Lusamine, because she is a mum. She was a mum. It's kind of spoilers. So you possibly could call... she could be called that four-letter word. And she probably is one. So, that's fine. The right style does wonders, you know? And how? Your style is a bit of wanting. I'll have to take you out sometime and help you pick out a smashing outfit. I think she just asked that Hal on a date. You do realize Hal's 11, right? Hal's got game. How has got game, ladies and gentlemen. How has got game. He just picked up a 40-year-old. Wow. Well done, Hal. Like, what to wear? I don't think anyone else could pull off that kind of look. Except for maybe Lily. Oh, don't worry. Don't you worry. Just leave everything to me. Trust me, children would be much happier if they would just listen to the adults around them. Children would be much happier if they listened to the adults around them. Sure. Say what you want. That tremor. Did something just happen on the lower floors? Oh dear. Hello, UB01. Did you come from another world? Miss Lusamine, stand back! That thing, it's not right! You poor creature. That hole, that Pokemon. What in the world are they? You poor creature. Joe! Can you distract that thing? I've got to get Miss Lusamine out of here. Stop it. You're not getting this girl. Leave her alone. She's like 40. You need to back away now. Wow. I'm being silly, aren't I? You know, I'm leaning too much into this whole thing. But like, you know, let's ship Hal and Lusamine together. Yeah, let's do Hal and Lusamine shipping. Okay, so there's a weird Pokemon here. Its aura is filled with defense stats. Go, Roxy! Roxy! Accelerock! Venusaur. That does like nothing to me because I'm not poison. Okay, that's a crit, but like, that's fine. There's no point in wasting a Z move on this Pokemon because it will run away eventually. I can't catch it here. I think I can. I don't even know if I can kill it. Wait. Can I catch it? No, I can't catch it. Okay. I don't even know if I can kill it. I might be able to. You might not live another... Yeah, you might not live another rock tomb. I can kill it! That's a crit! Nice! I did not realize I can kill it because it ran away on my main file when I did this battle. In my main file, it ran away. But I can kill it. Okay, so the unidentified creature disappeared. So it is true. I still need that Pokemon. I need to get it back. What? Miss Lusamine, did you say something? Look at that evil smile she just did. That creature we just saw was undoubtedly an Ultra Beast. Look at that smile. You can tell this girl's evil, but look at that smile. You know, I don't know if she's evil or not, but no spoilers in the comment section. Yeah, but because some people might have played up to that point, some people might not have played up to that point, so best be courteous on those people who have not played up to the points. But look at that smile. Just based on that one smile, you can tell this girl's evil. But that is an evil smile. You cannot get away from that. That is an evil smile. An unknowing being from another dimension that suddenly appears from an ultra wormhole. It looked like it was suffering. It pained it to come to this strange place. And I couldn't bear to see what happened. I will save it. And I will love it. Thank you both of you. Thank you so much. Wiki. These two are in the middle of their island challenge, aren't they? Please deliver them to the next island.
Ooh.
At once, ma'am. I will go back and check on none of the poor residents' Pokemon who came to harm. I need to speak to Mr. Fabio about exactly what happened downstairs. But of course, I will start preparing the foundation for our newest and perhaps greatest duty yet, the protection of Ultra Beasts. I'll see you two to Ula Ula Island then. Stop it, Hal. You've not got game here. Stop it, Hal. I'm sure you can get Lusamine's phone number if you want it, but like, I really don't think you got a chance here. I would have never actually... I never thought I'd actually get a chance to see an ultra wormhole in my life. I got to tell Professor Burnett about this next time I see her. I don't know if what would happen, what happened should be rightly described as an accident, but I think it's best if you do so. Anyway, I'm glad to meet you. Both of you, please take this to remember our visit. Some Malasadas for Hal. Yay! Big Malasada! Awesome! Isn't it crazy how Malasadas taste better when you eat them together with somebody else? I wouldn't know. I've never had Malasada. You know what? I gotta find a place that does Malasada. I gotta find a place. I gotta find or somewhere in the UK that does Malasada. I've gotta try this thing now. I'll try and make my own Malasada. I mean, I think it's just like fried bread or something like that. But yeah, I think I'm going to have to try my own I'm going to have to either make Malasada or find somewhere that makes Malasada. I'm going to have to find a bakery that makes Malasada. Because I need to try Malasada now. Hal has encouraged me to say that I need to try a Malasada. I need to find this. I need to find Malasada and I need to try it for myself. Yes, I think I know what you mean. Meals are always best, taste better when you share them with the ones you love. And for you, Joe, a TM for a move called Psychic. Wait, I get Psychic and he gets a Malasada? Wow, I got the better half of this deal. I hope you both have wondrous adventures on your island challenge. Yeah, I got the better half of this deal. Although I did kill our Ultra Beast, so I deserve the better half of that deal. I deserve the TM for Psychic in that case. Oh. My heart is still kind of racing, you know. The Ultra Wormhole is real, and Ultra Beasts are real too. The world is just way too big. I bet we'll discover even more new things on the next island tour. I'm going to I'm going to need all the energy I can get, so it's time we dig in. You want a Melisada?
I do, actually, but, you know, you're not going to give me one, are you?
Ah, so good. Shoot, I already ate the whole thing.
Well, that was quick.
And now we are all the way over here. On Ula Ula Island. Pelipper! 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 Okay, so there's a clothing shop and everything. Land ahoy! Alright. Terra firma under my foot again. Ula Ula Island is a place like totally different than Meli Meli or Aquila, right? I've got an idea. Let's have a battle, Joe.
Why?
I want my Pokemon to get a good deep breath with this fresh new air. Don't worry, I'll be sure that both of our teams are fighting form first.
Good, you healed me. Thank you.
Alright. Fine, at least we'll get a battle this episode. Because we haven't had one battle this episode yet. It's all been story. Oh, you have a Raichu now. Hey, Roxy. Accelerock. Actually, that does a lot of damage. That also does a lot of damage to me. Damn. Roxy's not fast enough to outspeed a Raichu, and of course... It does a lot of damage. Raichu does a lot of damage, and Roxy doesn't have any special, so I guess I wouldn't expect him to live that. Go on, Sophie. Nice. Roderick goes to level 44. Vaporeon. Well, let's bring Criminal out. Yeah, let's bring Criminal out for this. Vaporeon. I guess he has an evolution of different typings, because in my other game he had a Leaf. In my original file he had a Leafeon because I had a Popplio. And now because I have the Fire type. Yeah, so I'm guessing he gets the evolution to counter your typing. So it's either going to be Leafeon, Vaporeon, or Flareon, which is awesome. Not Jolteon. I mean, Jolteon's awesome, don't get me wrong. It's just that it's interesting to see a different evolution. Because you usually see Jolteon, but now you will see Leafeon instead. But House 1 is Leafeon on my main file. And a Dartrix. Okay. Can I want to bring my starter in? You know what? Yeah, I'm going to bring my starter in. I also wanted to bring in my flying type, but I don't really want to bring. I want to bring in my starter. Nice. Yeah, you flinch. Nice. Well done, Roderick.
Siege goes to level 33. Woody grows to level 33. Oh, it's time! Level 34 is time! Roderick is evolving! That's a beautiful way to end this episode! We have an Incineroar! Incineroar was added to your Pokédex. Okay. So we got the entire evolution line. Let's see what we got. The heal Pokémon. Wow. It's a heal. It's a heal Pokémon. This Pokémon, it has a violent, selfish disposition. It's not in the mood to listen. It will ignore its trainer's orders with complete nonchalance. Okay. I hope you actually don't ignore my orders, because I kind of want you to do what I say. But I don't mind you being a heel, you know? You can be a heel all you want. Oh, you're trying to learn Darkness Lariat. This is your signature move. Yeah, to hell with Bite. Darkness Lariat. Blah. That battle took my breath away. I can't breathe. The fresh air that way. We're supposed to meet up with the professor, right? Where? It was Melly Garden, right? Why? He would want us to go to the garden. I guess we'll find out when we get there, right? We've made it to Ula Ula Island now, big boy. That means a whole new island Pokédex. It's up to you to see what new Pokémon we can uncover, Joe. Zzz. Okay, I know one thing. This is a TM retailer. And you have a TM I want that would help me out in my next trial. Yeah, it's not here. There it is. Bulldoze. Yes, that'll help me out in my next trial. That will help me out in my next trial. And I know exactly who I want to give it to. Bulldoze. Okay, so I can't give it to Roxy. Fine, I will give it to Roderick. There we go. No one can learn Psychic. No one can learn Leech Seed. No one can learn Smart Strike. No, you can learn Grass Knot, but I don't really want you to. Ooh, you can learn Brutal Swing as well. But you already have Darkness Lariat, so I don't really need to give you Brutal Swing. Anyway, this is where I'm going to heal up. I'm going to end today's episode right here in this Pokemon Center, and probably end today's session too. So, let me heal up. And we'll end today's episode right here. Okay, so that is where the end of this episode is going to be. In today's episode, we went to the older paradise, and of course, we met up with Hal, and of course, we also had a battle with Hal right here on Ula Ula Island. And in the next episode, we'll start exploring Ula Ula Island, and we'll meet up with the professor in Mali Gardens. But until next time, if you enjoyed today's episode, you can leave a like, comment, and subscribe. But until next time, I'm JoshBeatsGames, and I am out. See you again!